Hello everyone, this is Priyanka from CS Priyanka's Professional Classes. After a long time, I'm coming on live in video. So today I'm here with the video business function from the subject business environment and law of CS Foundation. First of all, I would like to tell you sorry for making the chapter too much lengthy because I'm unable to exclude any of the topic from this chapter. So for your benefit, for your interest and for eye soothing purpose, I just distributed all slides. It took total 42 slides to complete this chapter. So I have divided this 42 slides into two video for you and business function, and I named it as part one and part two. And I will request you go through both the part one and two. And also same time I have uploaded the MCQs on this chapter, requesting you please go through the chapter first and please go through the MCQs also. It will definitely help you. So let's get started. Business function part one from business environment and law. Business functions. First, let us understand what do you mean by business functions. So if you want to elaborate from the name itself, so what are the that functions you do in a business or under a business, those are business functions. Now we can, in other terms, we also can say that activities which is carried out by the enterprise, that is also a function. Now business function is divided into two parts. One is core function, where you have to focus more. Other is support function, which functions are going to support your core function. Okay, so for example, you can say I am concentrating on some project. So my activities is to do the research and development for that project. Now what are the support is needed for doing such project? That means I have to make the team, I have to I have to arrange the proper money for doing such project. All these are support functions, which is supporting the core functions. You can say third point, core business function and activities which also help you to earn income, means income, okay, or to earn, okay, or to increase money, increase income. So it is directly or indirectly relates to the money, related to the money. Next is, whenever there's a production of final goods or services, okay, obviously there is a third party interference will be there. Okay, now whatever process you will fix or whatever operation is going to be performed routinely to carry on such function, it's actually for the mission of the organization, that is to achieve the goal. Business process also involves lots of division of labor between the multiple persons or technologies, because a business or an enterprise recruit lot of expertise, lot of people from different area. Like one is good in technology, or one good in accounts, one good in marketing. So all will means you are going to get the expertise from different specialized area, and they are going to come, they are multiple person obviously, and these labors are going to give you support to achieve the goal, okay, by functioning this from this core function, okay, by performing this core functions. For example, you can say this example I have included in this slide, that is, for example, you are having a publishing company. That means you publish books. Okay, now one person will write the material, other person will be there who is going to edit the same, or third party will be there who is going to add the graphics, or fourth person may print the same. So all this is, we called it a teamwork, and business process includes all. This is actually known as business function. Now, for every businessman, whenever an enterprise wants to achieve the goal, they
cannot achieve the goal without making any strategy. So second topic is strategy. What do you mean by strategy? I can say you, it's a different level of plan. Strategy means to achieve the goal. So the term strategy is derived from the Greek word strategos, which means the art of the general. This is nothing but a plan of action which is designed to achieve a long-term or overall aim. So you need to do the strategy to achieve the long-term goal objectives. Strategy is also a high-level plan which achieve one or more goal under the conditions of uncertainty. So, uncertainty means which may happen, which may not happen in the future. You don't even know. Okay. But for achieving the goal, there is obviously you have to take the risk in a business to achieve a long-run goal. So, maybe the thing is the conditions are uncertain in nature. That means it's not, you don't know whether you are going to, you can achieve or not. In such cases, you have to do the strategy. So strategy is a high level plan, which you have to do, okay, for this uncertain conditions to achieve certain goals for a long run. Okay, so obviously every enterprise have to take certain risk, okay, to achieve the goal. Without taking a risk, you cannot achieve the goal. So that high level plan, we called it as strategy. Now let us read some of the features of strategy. Like what are the features or characteristics of strategy? This is a specialized plan. Already I said it's a high level plan just to outperform the competitors. Okay, because whenever you are competing with the good enterprise or popular enterprise, branded enterprise, you have to do the strategy because they will go far more from you. They do the strategy at certain different level. So to win or to compete with those people, you have to do a specialized, you have to take some specialized plan. That is known as strategy. Now, details about how managers must respond to any change in the business environment, that also needs to be included in strategy. Because normally, you know, manager manage the things in an enterprise. Now, how they're going to respond if any changes happen? Because strategy we take under certain uncertain conditions. Okay, so their response also matters. So that is also coming under the characteristics of strategy. Strategy will redefine the direction towards the common goal. Maybe it is uncertain, it's a common goal, but if you take a proper strategy, okay, if you do the plan, it will help you to move towards towards that direction of common goals. It also reflects the concern to effectively mobilize the resources. It used to reflect all those resources which will help you to achieve the goal, and obviously if you do the strategy, it maximizes the organization's chances to achieve the set goals or set objectives, whichever is uncertain in nature. So means definitely if you do a proper strategy, if you do the proper planning, and if you have budget, it will help you, or it will give you the chances. It will give the organization the chances to achieve the set objectives or goal in future. You can do strategies at different level of business. There are three level. One is corporate level, other one is business level, and thirdly functional level. So corporate level, we can say you have to think from the perspective of the company or body, corporate level. Business level, those main aim is to earn money, okay, or whose main aim is to yielding income. That business level, from that business level you have to do the strategy. And finally, the people who will perform, okay, during that time, you have to take the strategies from the functional level. So there are three levels: corporate, business, and functional. corporate level, strategy is when a business makes a decision that affects the whole company. I already said that corporate level means you have to take the strategy, you have to do the planning from the company's perspective. That means a corporate level strategy means you have to take such strategy which should not affect the whole company. And also, obviously, it will help you to compete with the other competitors and to continue to offer a unique product or service to the consumer. This type of strategy is known as corporate level strategy. Secondly, come to business level. Just you have to come one level down. Business level strategies, it's a detailed action taken to provide value to the customer. Obviously, because here in the business level, your aim is to earn money or earn profit. So here you have to satisfy the customer. So here the main thing is, whatever you will take the strategy, it should not affect the consumer or customer. And also it will help you to gain. Okay. So it will give obviously a value to customers, and it will help you to gain a competitive advantage by exploiting the core competencies. And also this here, actually the customer, consumer, they are main thing. So they are the foundation or essence of the organization's business strategy. So whenever you will take the strategy from the business level, you have to think, or you have to do it for the benefit or interest of the customer. And thirdly, functional level, this strategy, the actions or goal, whatever is assigned to various departments, they actually give support to this previous two level, that is corporate level as well as business level. So functional means what? They actually do the work, they actually function, they perform. So they actually give support to the business level and corporate level strategy. So the strategies actually specify the outcome, whatever you want to see, okay, to achieve for the daily operations, every regular activity, all these work. Okay, so how they will do, what will be the strategy for them to operate, operation, performance, this will come under the functional level. Now, definition of planning, let's discuss. William H. Newman and Charles E. Summer Jr. said that the process of planning covers a wide range of activities, all the way from initially sensing that something needs doing to firmly deciding who does, what and when. It is more than a logic or imagination of judgment. It is a combination of all these that culminates in a decision. A decision about what should be done. The decision phase of planning is too important that we should use the expression decision making as a synonym of planning. Now, just I would like to say, give you interpretation in one line. That is, William H. Newman and Charles E. Summer Jr. is telling that planning is nothing but it's a wide range of activities. It's nothing but a logic or imagination of judgment. So, for planning or to take the decisions. Actually, this is a decision. Planning means whenever you are setting to plan something, you have to take the decision. And that taking decision, you should be eligible to take decision, or you should be capable of taking decision. That means you should have the imagination power of the judgment, what is right and what is wrong. And finally, decision making. These are all highlighted words, the interpretation from this definition. Second definition I have mentioned of Richard N. Fermer and Barry M. Bridgman. He said the planning function determines organizational objectives and the policies, programs, schedules, procedure and methods for achieving them. Planning is essentially decision making since it involves choosing among the alternatives, and it also encompasses innovation. Thus, planning is the process of making decision on any phase of organized activity. So guys, I have highlighted the portion which he wants to say. That is, planning is nothing but a policy. It is nothing but a program. schedules, procedure and methods to achieve certain goals. These all you are going to plan it. And obviously, this is one of the logic and innovation. You have to innovate something to achieve certain goal. That is actually planning. And finally, decision. The other word of the planning is decision. You have to decision. You have to decide something to achieve some objective. So that is only the planning. So Richard actually focused on these terms, that is policies, programs, schedules, procedure, methods, innovation, decision. Next is, what do you mean by planning? So planning means what? I have given some points. It is, first of all, though, we have read from the definition that planning is nothing but a decision. Lot of words we have said, so you can write of your own if you want to write. So just go through these points. This is deciding of what is to be done in advance. Planning is like, in advance you have to decide what you will do in future. That is planning. It is a groundwork for all future plans of the organization. So whatever organization will do in future, you have to beforehand you have to do some work, groundwork for that, for taking, and you have to take some decision for that. It plan bridges the gap between where the organization currently finds itself and where it wishes to be. So planning is nothing but it will show the organization that where you are standing now and after 5 years or 6 years where he wants to go. Next, business planning comprises of setting objectives for the organization, and it will help you to develop a plan of action to achieve these objectives. Obviously, managers are a very important part of function of business planning, because in an organization, usually managers, occupier in an industry, they usually help you to take the, means they will take the plan, they will do the planning, they will help you to take the decisions, and they will make the strategy, how the all the strategy from all the levels to achieve the goals in future. Obviously, it requires innovation. It also requires creativity, because there should be something new, innovative, the idea should come from the mind to take decisions. It is also a multitasking from the manager's side. And planning provides a sense of direction. Whatever planning you will do, it will help you for a sense of direction. That means it will show you a direction towards to achieve the objectives, okay, towards the future objectives. And also it's a type of a sense of direction. It will show you some way out to achieve that. That is actually planning. Next important thing after planning is budgetary control. So whenever you will plan something, next question will come whether you are having budget or not. Okay, for such thing. So we called it budgetary control. Budgetary control is nothing but a process of preparation of budgets of various activities and comparing the budget figures for arriving at deviation, if any, which are to be eliminated in future. So you have to fix the budget to achieve certain objective. It is a continuous process which will help you in planning, obviously in coordination also. And this is a method of control. So if you don't have money, how you're going to achieve the goal? So that's why you have to fix the money of various activities to achieve the future objectives, and this is actually a continuous process, and it will provide a method of control. The comparison of budget figures with actual figures will help the management to find out variances and take corrective actions without any delay. So obviously you have to compare the what is the budget figure or budgeted figure and the actual figure. Well, this will help you to management, okay, and to take some corrective actions also without any delay. So in what way you're going to achieve the goal, or you are going to plan, you are going to take the strategy, what manpower you need, everything is depends on the budget. And for that method of fixing the budget is known as budgetary control. lot of budgets are there. So sales budget, production budget, because there are different departments are there, and means in an enterprise. And there are different types of budget: sales, production, capital, cash budget, marketing budget, project budget, revenue budget, expenditure budget. Different under these things, you have to fix the budget and you have to control it. So, referring to the previous slide, let us discuss the purpose of such budget. So, first is we discuss like sales budget, which will specify the expected sales of goods during the periods. Production, it will help you to, it will specify the volume of production during the different period. Material budget will also will specify the estimated some quantity or cost of material during the different volumes of production. Cash budget will specify expected cash inflow, outflow, what is your net liquidity position of your company. All this will help you, this cash budget. Working capital, you know, it's actually deals with inventory. Okay, working capital. So it's available. Working capital means investment. You are investing in the current asset, like inventory, budget, debtors, okay, etc. At different point of time. Profitability budget specify that different level of sales and how much sales happened and expected profit level they are going to specify. R&D budget. R&D means research and development. They are going to estimate the expenditure and to carry out research and development. That means for researching and doing this R&D, for doing this research and development, there how much amount they have spent and the specify the estimated what actual expenditure can happen. Okay, that they are going to specify. There are some features of budgetary control. For example, budget, if you means this budgetary control, or if you fix the budget, it will help you to determine the goals, determination of goal. It will help attainment of goals, laying out of plan. It will help you to do the comparison, and obviously it will help you to take the corrective decision, or it will help you to revise the thing. So these are the characteristics of budgetary control. Advantages of budgeting. It will clearly define you the goals and objectives. Budgeting will help you to think now and plan for future. It will help you to allocate resources. It will simply uncover the potential bottlenecks, whatever is disadvantages, or like bottleneck in the sense you can say ki the narrow section of your enterprise they are going to uncover. So from the first only you will, it will be clear to you. Okay, next is coordinate activities. It will help you to coordinate with others and to do the team work to achieve the goal. And obviously it will help you in communication plans whenever you are going to communicate. So these are the advantages of budgeting. Now research and development is a topic like for doing a particular job, or to, you can say, to take decision for achieving the goals in future under uncertain conditions, or to do a particular project, we need lot of research and development. That means we have to research, we have to study, we have to work out on those specific things. So for research and development, you need something that is innovation. You should have that innovation power for doing research and development. Now research and development under innovation, there are some terms we have to use to like analysis. Under research and development, what you do actually, you analyze the matter. You research the matter, your creativity. After that, your creativity will come. You will create something new. And you will develop something. So from the research, you are going to develop. So that is known as research and development. Some factors are there affecting location of business. Okay, many factors are there which actually affects the location of business, where your business is situated or located. First of all is communication. So communication means road, rail, air. This includes transport facilities. The transport facilities should be proper. Infrastructure should be good. Okay, then only your business can do better. Otherwise, it will affect the location. This can affect your location of the business, because these transport links are particularly important in the business, delivers products, okay, sale direct using a sales force or independent or import export, everything. Like this fool is going to depend, this communication system, if it is not good, then it can affect the location of the business. Labor. When a startup needs to hire employees, in such cases, this location of business is very important. Then access to a reliable pool of staff, where you are going, and reliable pool of staffs with relevant skill is important, and those people will not go if your location is not proper. Next is market, customers, population. For example, startup companies may need to be located near particular centers of population. For example, if the product is a service targeted at affluence older aged people, then it is important to be located where there is a sufficient population of such people. Okay, so that means you have to, your business should be located or situated in that place where maximum of the correspondences are there. Next is suppliers. The business actually depends on the suppliers at a certain time, and a because of a supplier supplies raw materials, and a business to run a company or business and enterprise, they need raw materials. Okay, for production purpose, for manufacturing purpose, they need raw materials. So suppliers are, from that perspective, they are very important. So cost will be lower if the business located near the sources of supply, obviously. So the suppliers, if you are very much, your business if situated or located near to the supplier's location, then the cost will be lower. Okay, otherwise it will impact on the price. So obviously it will affect the location of the business. And finally, lastly is a government assistance. Government policy has often designed to influence the location of new assistance business. So your location policy, it's also going to affect the location, because government policy, whenever the government makes the policy for the business, for assisting the business, okay, so your location will matters, okay, to convince the government or to obtain such assistance from the government. Decision making means, it's a part of planning, like you are taking decisions. Maybe it is alternatives, because you are taking decisions, many decisions you have to take. One, it's a alternative, you can say, alternative decisions you have to take. Whatever decisions you are taking, it's totally uncertain in nature. That means contingent in nature. You don't know whether it can you will succeed or not by taking that decision or from that decisions. It's totally uncertain in nature. High risk consequences are there, because you are totally don't know the decisions you have taken, whether it is a right or wrong. So it totally involves high risk consequences. Interpersonal issues can come from the decision making, because it's an individual work. So you are taking decision, others may have some issues relating to that decisions, and it will increase complexity. If you, this decision making is relates to the complexity. Complexity is one of the negative things. Okay, because your decision may not be liked by the other person, so it will increase the complex. So these are all the different types under decision making. Now, government policy, we have read that in the before slide. So what do you mean by this government policy? This is nothing but a rule or principle. It will help the enterprise or organization, or it will guide the organization to take decision, to take better decision, and obviously which will resulting in positive outcomes from taking that decision, and to get assistance from the government. Okay, it may result in like positive outcomes may be there. and it will help you to enhance the community or unit. Such thing we called it government policy. Difference between manufacturing function and service function. So manufacturing word means what? You are manufacturing. Manufacturing involves like from the cutting, okay, from the cutting, packing, making, okay, production, everything. It involves everything till sell. It's coming under the manufacturing. Okay, and service function means the service means it's going to support the manufacturing function. So let's see what's written. Manufacturing operation produce tangible goods. Tangible means which you can touch and feel, which are physical products. Because you are manufacturing one product, so obviously you can touch it, you can feel it, how is it? And that can be held and seen. That's why it's tangible. On the other hand, service operation provides certain intangible service. Service means someone is giving service. Okay, it's a good one, but you cannot touch it. That's why it is intangible service. Only you can feel it. And that may not be easily identifiable. You cannot means because one tangible means you can touch the product in case of manufacturing. But in case of service, you can feel it, how the whether the service is good or not, but you cannot touch the service. That's why it's intangible in nature. So this is I have distributed. These are all 20 slides I have included in this part one video of business function. Okay. Hope you will like it, and if you like, please don't forget to hit the like, subscribe and share button, and please check the part 2 also, business function part 2 video. There I have included another 21 slides, so just check it and see you soon.